Well, every year, hundreds of thousands of men and women receive a stent to live longer. The stent helps keep blood vessels open. In depth tonight, Brian Mastre reports on how local researchers armed with a $3.5 million grant are trying to come up with a longer-lasting stent.
Every Monday, Jim Fallon and some friends take on a different Metro golf course. On this day, it's Johnny Goodman in Omaha.
It was a struggle just walking from the tee box to the cart. I mean, it got awful tiring after a while. I mean, I could probably play about 9 holes and then I'd probably have to go home, you know, and rest.
Always a tough crowd. His playing partners offered no mulligans for the excruciating pain in his legs.
They were giving me a hard time, you know. These guys show no mercy.
A year ago, he found out what was wrong. He had blockages in the arteries in his legs.
It got so bad that I could walk probably 100 yards. And then I had severe pain and I had to sit down and rest. And my legs were really weak. I mean, I had no strength whatsoever in the legs.
Used to be the sort of blockage that he had would have required a very large abdominal operation that would take several weeks to recover from.
But as with most procedures, medicine advances. Instead of major surgery, he received stents and went home the next day.
The next day, I could walk around without any pain. It was amazing.
A few weeks later, he traveled to Italy for his 45th wedding anniversary and walked all over the place with his wife. Here at University of Nebraska Medical Center, experts are trying to solve another problem.
There's the knee in the middle, and then this is the artery, and those are the branches that go from the artery.
Unlike stents in the heart, stents in the legs don't last long. Many patients need a new one 2 years later.
We're trying to figure out why this happens. That's the first question. And then the second question that we're trying to address is which of these stents are better to use for each specific patient. It is better to put the stent.
Alexei Kaminsky isn't a doctor, he's an engineer. The artery in the leg bends and twists, contracts and expands. That's why the stents don't last as long.
Especially, you know, with different kinds of anatomies.
Dr. Jason McTaggart often leaves the clinic and ventures into the lab with the engineers.
This one's is a 6.5.
It allows me to better translate the medicine to the engineers, and it allows them to translate the engineering to, you know, the medicine people.
They're trying to create a longer lasting stent for the leg.
And we actually do a lot of experiments together. If we can, you know, reduce the failure rate of stents in half, you know, that'll, you know, cut down on a lot of recurrent operations people need to have, time in the hospital, and, you know, as we said before, you know, a good deal of healthcare resources that then can be diverted to other things.
Perhaps someday, based on the work at UNMC, the stents in Jim Fallon's legs will last as long as the ones in his heart.
I've got stents in my heart that were put in 2001.
Go in.
Because it's not just about golfing, it's about quality of life. In Omaha with photographer Jim Hinchick, I'm Brian Mastre reporting, WWT 6 News.